Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how to trigger a flow in Salesforce Lightning. Before start, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to detail or description of this video. So you will find various links of playlists related to Salesforce videos, so you can follow them. Now I'm going to explain this. So this is auto launch flow that I already created. So if you create auto launch flow, so you will have the start button. So if you double click on this, so you will be having various options through which you can identify how your flow will be launches. So choose the flow trigger. So there are three options to trigger the flow. So first option is default, that is selected automatically. So it is users or apps, no flow trigger. So if you read the description related to first option, so it says without a flow trigger, you set up other things to launch the flow. So if you don't want to launch your flow automatically, so then you need to launch your flow through custom buttons, processes, Apex classes, or even Einstein bots. So through these options, you can launch your auto launch flow. Then if you want to launch your flow or want to trigger your flow automatically, then you can choose second or third option. So second option says new or updated records. Flow makes fast field updates, right? So here, if you read this description, this flow can only update fields on the records that launches the flow before the record is saved to the database. When you use an assignment element to set the record global variables fields, Salesforce updates that records field for you. So here you can see three options are available. So you can choose a particular way through which you want to launch or trigger your flow. So whenever a record is created or updated, or both, whether it is created or updated, so your flow will be triggered. You can also select the object on which you want to apply this. So I selected opportunity object. So whenever opportunity is created, updated, or both created or updated, whatever option you selected, accordingly this flow will be launched. So object is important because without that, you cannot decide like for which object it will be triggering automatically. Now, third option is scheduled jobs. So if you want to run or launch your flow at a particular date time and at particular frequency, so you can choose third option, that is scheduled jobs. So flow runs for a batch of records. The flow starts only at the scheduled time and frequency. So here you can pick a particular date, you can set a particular time, or you can choose frequency like once, daily, or weekly. So accordingly, flow will be triggered. And here you can read the detail like run the flow for a set of records. So this is optional. So find Salesforce records that meet filter conditions and start a flow interview for each of those records. Values from each record are stored in the records global variable. So here you can choose a particular object. Let's say I'm choosing opportunity. So these things are optional. These are not required. So selecting object and there are options like get all opportunity records or you want to fetch as per condition. So if you select first option, all record will be fetched. And if you click on second option, so here you need to put some conditions. So you can put more conditions as well. So, but this is optional, and if you set date and time and frequency, so accordingly it will be executed as per that schedule. So mentioning the object and records are optional. So these are three ways through which you can launch your flow. So first was users or app, that is by default, and rest of two depends upon your requirement. And if you open any screen flow and you double click on this, so it will not show any option because screen flow, you need to interact with the user, so it doesn't execute in the background. So for this, either you can launch it through quick action or you can use directly on record pages. So this schedule option is only available on AutoLaunch Flow. So these options you can use accordingly. So I hope this information will help you to use AutoLaunch Flow in better way. And if you want to watch more Salesforce or Lightning Flow related videos, you can go to detail or description of this video. You can find links of various playlists related to Salesforce. So do watch them. Thank you for watching this video.